Good morning, everybody. How is everybody doing today? I hope all is well and well indeed. Happy Monday. Of course, this is the lady herself back here again, See Temptation, with another commentary of Chicago Talk. I wanted to begin this commentary, of course, by saying namaste. Peace be unto you and everybody that is watching this video. I hope everybody's doing well and staying safe and doing the right thing and doing what they're supposed to be doing. I got a couple of updates I wanted to report today. One is the update about Snoop Dogg and about R. Kelly. Now, beginning with Snoop, I read this morning online, which I find this quite interesting, which I think a lot of, especially the people in our community, they need to follow suit on this. I read this morning, allegedly, that Snoop Dogg is supposed to be starting a new wine line, and the name of it is called Snoop Cali Red Wine. It's supposed to hit the shelves sometime this summer for $12 a bottle. And he did get with a company. It's supposed to be with Snoop Dogg and 19 Crimes. Now, they said that in these bottles of wine, it's supposed to feature 65% Petite Sirah, and then 30% Zinfandel, and then 5% Merlot. So, which I thought I do applaud him for that, though, because I think that is an excellent thing to, you know, earn some income on the side. I just wish our people would just try to follow suit, though, you know, because with this virus going on, this crisis, you know, and then this violence going on, especially in Chicago, people need to really take heed of that, though. And as far as with Snoop, I think that's an excellent idea, what he did, what he's doing, starting his own wine line. And I do applaud him for that, though, and I hope he becomes very successful. I wouldn't mind trying it myself, though, because it do sound like it's pretty good, because, you know, I sip on wine sometime, and I don't see anything wrong with it. But people really need to come together and learn how to support each other, because, I mean, let's face it, we basically are on our own, and we really need to come together with love and try to support each other, support our businesses. If you have a special talent, you know, people in our community need to start supporting that. So, yeah, so I want to give Snoop Dogg definitely a thumbs up on that, and I hope it's successful. And, yeah, so on to the main story about the update on R. Kelly. I just found this out. I got some good information. Now, based on what I gathered, they said that he's facing charges as it stands right now in Brooklyn, New York, and in Chicago, but this is like federal charges that he's facing. So his trial for Brooklyn, New York is supposed to be on September 29th, so it's the day before my birthday, but hey, what can you do? And, the trial for Brooklyn, New York is supposed to be on September 29th, and the trial in Chicago was pushed back to October 13th. And the way it stands right now, that recently he was denied bail in New York. And the reason why he was denied bail, though, because he is currently in custody, if you already know. The reason why it was denied bail, because of the risk that he will flee. You know, in other words, they consider him a flight risk, or attempt to obstruct or threaten or intimidate prospective witnesses. So that's the reason why he's currently in custody, and he's been in custody since last summer. But if you ask me personally, I really feel, though, that he's going to be serving the rest of his life in prison. I mean, I know I'm going to have a lot of kickback on that. Everybody's talking about support R. Kelly. Let me tell y'all something, and I'm just being straight up, and I'm going to address this to all the haters, okay? It's one thing if you don't agree with me. That's fine. I mean, I have no problem with that, because everybody has, you know, their own opinion. I respect that. But in the same breath, if you want to sit up here and kick out any type of hate comments or negative comments, take that shit elsewhere. Because let me be real about one thing. This is my channel. Again, this is Chicago Talk, and this is ran by See Temptation. And I don't have time to be sitting up here, and matter of fact, I am too damn old to be sitting up here and trying to people please everybody. That's not my style. I'm going to speak the truth. I'm going to keep it 100. You know, and if you disagree with me, then guess what? Go start your own channel. I mean, I never knock anybody for starting their own thing. You know, if you want to start your channel, that's fine. But don't come on my channel trying to, like, throw darts at me and shades at me because of a matter of opinion. You know, if you disagree with me, cool. You know, you could express your opinion, but do it in a positive and respectful type of way. But don't come over here and try to throw darts at me and throw shades at me, because guess what? If you throw any, if you leave any type of negative comments on this channel, I promise you and guarantee you that your comments will be blocked and deleted. You know, because I don't have the time or the patience for that, you know. I was on PT Showbiz Top 5. As a matter of fact, he did a live show last week. And he does do drag shows, you know. And he did made a real good comment. He was saying that, hey, you know, everybody has their own differences of opinions. That's fine and well. But when you start throwing any type of negativity or trying to, you know, throw any type of haterism out there, then guess what? You know, don't watch the channel. You know, move on to something else, you know. Because either way it goes, at the end of the day, it's not paying my bills. I'm just doing this for the love of this and to bring some sort of truth to the people. That's the reason why I've been doing this channel, been still pushing and doing this channel for the last 3 years. I may not put out as many videos like I used to because trying to manage a full-time job and trying to manage my health issues and trying to deal with my mom and stuff, you know, that is hard. And I don't have any type of help, okay? So, you know, I do this for the love of it, you know, because I love, you know, communicating. I love to speak to people. And I just speak facts and speak truth. If you like it, cool. You know, if you want to ride with me, cool. If you don't, then that's fine with me. Either way it goes. Okay. So back to this issue, this story with R. Kelly. So, yeah. So that's the reason why that his bond was denied. And the attorneys prefer to go to trial first in Brooklyn, New York, and then to Chicago. So, yeah, that's all that I have as far as the update on that, though. So his trials, again, are set in Brooklyn for September 29th and in Chicago for October 13th. But, yeah, but personally, I don't think he's getting out of jail. I think, you know, those days, you know, he should have learned all that on his first trial. So, you know, anything you do negatively is going to come back on you 100-fold. And I think he pretty much knows, though, that his days are pretty much numbered. I mean, I don't care how much money he has in the bank or how famous he is. The bottom line is when you're talking about violating young girls, children at that, you know, no, that's a big time no-no. And another thing I wanted to express is this as well. My thing is, why is it that R. Kelly has to go down for all these charges? I think all the people that should go down for this is between him, his road manager, former road managers, the parents, you know, of these kids. All of them should go down and serve time for this, because when you're talking about violating kids, no, I have a serious problem with that. You know, and then with him being a year younger than I am, he knows better, you know. But my thing is, hey, if you know better, you do better. But, you know, considering the circumstance, what he went through when he was molested as a child and then growing up, I mean, it's a sad situation. But the bottom line is, though, if a crime was committed, then he's got to serve the time for it. And that's one of the reasons why they're not going to, that's why he was denied bond, knowing that, not to mention that he is a flight risk and they're scared that he might intimidate potential witnesses. So, but anyway, ladies and gentlemen, please leave a comment, not any negative comments, just leave a comment on the bottom. Let me know what you think about these two stories about Snoop Dogg and R. Kelly. And the main thing that I ask for the most, I'm trying to get up to 3,000 subscribers before this year is out. I ask you again to share and subscribe and smash that like button. Let me know what you think. And like I said, I don't have a problem with you expressing your opinions. I mean, that's cool. I read everybody's comments, you know, and I comment, reply afterwards. But any negativity, don't waste your time on this channel, though, because that's one thing I will not tolerate, and that's any negativity on this channel, period, point blank, in a story. So, but on that note, guys, I'm going to go ahead and end this video. I saw that in those two stories this morning, I read up on it, I wanted to drop a video on this. So, guys, I wanted to say that I love you, I bless you, I have faith in you, and I realize the Creator in each and every one of you. And guys, like I said, we're going to continue to stay prayed up regardless of this crisis, you know, hoping and praying the economy opens back up real soon, because people do need to get back to work. You know, people do have families to take care of. They have kids and stuff, you know. But in the same breath, you know, all the people are entitled to divine health and to stay safe. All right. So on that note, I'm going to go ahead and exit out. So guys, have a wonderful Monday. You guys stay safe. Keep the prayers up. You know, continue to meditate and vibrate. And until the next video, like I said, I'll check you guys later. And See Temptation is up and out. So I say namaste and peace out.